bit Section 7 forever and ever. And I'm moving us into Section 8 right now about who violates the octet rule. And in my notes, I think it's on page 76, I have a draft, and you have, hopefully, the cleaned up version. In Section 7-8, or you can look in your book, there are four rules about who violates the octet rule. And let's go through them, and then we're going to take an example of each. Okay, if you'll look up there, you already know rule one. Hydrogen only needs two. Okay, we knew that. That's an always, always, always thing for us. Now, rule two. If you have beryllium, actually, you could make it more general and say something from the 2A family. But the main one that does this is beryllium. It's in the central atom in a compound that has covalent character, it will need four. Now, let me explain that a little bit. When I started chapter 7 today, if I said we had beryllium chloride, okay, this is section 1 of, or section 2. Okay, you look over there and you find beryllium, BE. And then chloride, you look over there, big jump across, and you would say ionic, and I would say, yes, you're right. However, life is not that simple. That when you start learning this, at the first of chapter 7, we talk about this is ionic or this is covalent, and life is black and white. It's one way or the other 100%, and that's a lot. It's really a continuum. You can have a covalent substance that has some ionic character. You can have a covalent, I said that would be opposite, you can have two. Okay? So, there's a lot of things in between. Okay? I guess the best analogy, male and female. You know, most men are tall. But there are some tall women. There are some women with little mustaches. We usually think of facial hair for men. Okay, so, you know, yeah, we talk about male and female, but hey, there's a lot of characteristics, but there's a lot of in-between, you know, crossover there. So here, that for beryllium chloride, if you make it under the right conditions, it will have some covalent character. And if it does, it needs four on beryllium. It violates the octet rule, and that's an always, always for us. Okay, then rule three. Is an always for us. If you have boron or other things from the 3A and it's in some compound, now you might think since you have some metals in the 3A, metal over to here, and you might think, oh, it's ionic. It could have ionic character, or depending upon experimental conditions, it could have covalent character. So if I say, treat this thing as covalent, if boron or other 3A atoms are the central atoms in compounds with covalent character, they'll need six, not eight. Does anybody see a pattern? Hydrogen was in the 1A and it needed how many? Two. Beryllium is in the 2A and it needed how many? Four. Boron is in the 3A and it needs six. Okay, then rule four is terrible because it's sometimes, and I'll come back to it in a moment, but let's take a couple of examples. Okay.
So are we changing what we
thought before? Okay, let me answer this first and then I'll get to you. Okay, if I have a question and I just make you say, it's this or it's this, okay, go with the first part of this chapter. If I said beryllium chloride, which do you think it is? Tell me ionic. Okay? And we'll treat life as black or white. Okay? Now, Meredith.
But what is it really? Then, like, on a test, would you ever ask us what it is?
Okay. Again, if I phrase it, it's got to be this or it's got to be that. Tell me ionic.
Okay.
Okay, but if I come over here, I write this down, and if I say, do the Lewis dot structure for this partially covalent substance, then treat it as covalent.
as the rule.
Yeah, but if I say use that S is equal to N minus A, if you're using it on it, we are treating it as though it is covalent. I know that is a confusing sticking point, okay? All right, I have this compound and I want us to go through S is equal to N minus A. Keeping in mind rule two, we've already worked with rule one twice, with water and with ammonia. Okay, beryllium needs how many, Nina?
Four.
Four. Each chlorine needs how many, Andrew?
Eight.
Okay, so 16 and 4, we have a need of 20. Let's think about what is available. Charles, how many does the beryllium come with?
Where's that?
2A family.
Two.
Two. I have two chlorines, and each chlorine comes with how many, Aaron? Seven. Okay, so we have 16 available. Notice, even number, if the numbers have come out odd, I think, I've probably made a math error. Okay, so share will be what? Anybody? Four. Who's the central atom? Beryllium, because we have just one of it. So I put it in the middle. I build around it. Does not matter where I put those chlorines. Can be the sides, the top, the bottom, doesn't matter. Just put them there. Okay? Any triples?
No.
No.
Any doubles?
No.
No. Just singles. Single, single. How many more pairs on each chlorine do I need?
Three pairs.
Do I want any more on beryllium?
No.
No, it likes four. Okay, check it out. We're sharing four.
Great.
Two, four. Available is 16. Count them. Always count them. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. If that doesn't work out, you got trouble somewhere. Okay, so does everybody have an octet that wants it? Chlorine does. Chlorine does. Beryllium doesn't want it. It wants four. Rule two, it's happy. Okay? So if I say, go use the Lewis dot structure on this substance, and I'm thinking, use that thing, then I'm thinking it's got some covalent character. Let's do another one. Let's do a rule three. Does anybody have a question on this?
No, I understand it.
Okay, good. Let's take this substance. Here's my thinking process. When I see a compound like this, I look at it first, and I've got these rules in my head. And I think, do I see anything that violates in here? That's my first question I always ask. I see boron. I go, yeah, it's going to violate. It's going to need six, not eight, because I know rule three. Will that be up on test day? No, because you're going to do so many of these. And lab 15 is doing these things. Now, you can't do all of lab 15 yet if all you know is what you've done here with me. But you can start Lewis dot structures on whatever number of compounds are there and ions. Oh, my God, look how far we are. I was having a wonderful time. Didn't everybody? Yeah. I know you weren't having as much fun as I was. So we will not do boron trichloride right now.